Last night's storms caused significant flooding in the South Hills, and once again, Banksville Road looked more like a river than a busy road. The floodwaters last night on Banksville Road were so high that they swept away a dumpster.
KDKA investigator Andy Sheehan takes a look at why flooding in the Banksville section of the city continues, even after a lot of money was spent to fix it.
Folks on Hayson Avenue have come to fear the rain. Twice this week alone, it's flooded their driveways and basements with storm water and raw sewage.
It's sewage. We are getting sewage backups in the basement, laundry room. We have a small bathroom downstairs. The shower fills up with raw sewage.
2 years ago, I did a story on this very street about a $1.7 million PWSA project to capture floodwaters in an underground containment tank and soak up the rest in these porous bioswale gardens.
It was supposed to fix the flooding. What happened?
It did not fix the flooding. It only has made it worse.
Residents here say the underground containment tank is way too small, instead causing storm sewer backups. And rather than soak up the water, these little gardens have only clogged the drains with runoff mulch.
This is supposed to be a model for the whole city.
We were told this is the pilot project.
Right.
If this is the pilot project, Pittsburghers, beware, because your homes are in danger.
Bernadette Hughes has spent $20,000 replacing washers, dryers, and heaters while trying in vain to protect her home with sandbags.
This is our homes. We can't even get into our driveways. We're blocked off.
And while PWSA does not believe their solution has made matters worse, it concedes it's been no match for the recent rains.
Well, it was designed for a certain level storm, and obviously these intense storms are overwhelming what we've designed for.
And they say they'll be working with the neighbors on short-range solutions like fixing the rain gardens and raising the curbs while looking for a longer-term fix down the road.
But folks here are at wit's end and say tweaking won't suffice as they live in fear of one more heavy rain. In the Banksville section of the city, Andy Sheehan, KDKA-TV News.